is your friends, who you choose to spend time with. Is that you, you know, if you got a lot of time in a day and you're hanging out with different people, you're going doing different things, take heed to this warning. The Bible says, he that walketh with wise men shall be wise. Try to find people from church, people who are like-minded believers to spend your time with. You know, you have other people who believe similarly. It's going to be a lot easier, a lot less of a draw into doing things that you already know aren't right. You know, when you got a bunch of worldly friends, they're saying, hey, we're all going to the movies. We're going to see this movie or whatever. And it's some way. I mean, they're all wicked movies out there these days. Anyways, I'm not going to prove that to you tonight. That's another sermon for another time. But if you don't want to end up doing that, you know, if you don't have a bunch of friends that are all about that, that's going to be a lot less likely for you to be tempted to go. But on the other hand, if you're spending time with some other people who love God, love the Bible, who like those same things, who have the Holy Spirit because they're children of God, those are the people who, you know, that's, you're going to rub off on each other and kind of have a little bit more accountability also. I remember there was a time when early on when I was still going to church, or when I first started going to church, the Faithful Word Baptist Church, and I was trying, you know, growing a lot spiritually and really, you know, doing my best, trying to get rid of things that I knew were wrong. It's a process too, and you know, don't feel bad if like you still have some things in your life that you know you need to get rid of. Like, just deal with it. Right. But there is, you know, there's time of growth that people need to experience. So one of the things for me, an example that comes to mind is when I finally realized, because one of the, we were talking about this last time with Brother Devin this morning, you know, music has always been a big part of my life, and especially the worldly music. It's been it's just been part of me almost for as long as I could remember. Since I was young, I always loved music. And when I got into music, I got into it, you know, the posters and the concerts and the t-shirts and even down to reading books about these guys and, you know, everything I could, getting the magazines, the rocker magazines, and just reading all this stuff and just wanting to know everything about it and really being into it. I needed to make a clean break from that stuff when I realized, because for a long time, I knew it wasn't right. It doesn't take, you know, some of the music especially, you don't have to even read the Bible cover to cover one time to realize they're talking about some really wicked things. You know, when they're glamorizing the booze and the fornication and adultery and, you know, all these things that are just so apparently wrong, you know you shouldn't be listening to that stuff anyways. But one of the things that I had to do, because this was a real problem, I mean, I got the sound system in my car, I had everything, just, I mean, I loved the music. I had the bootlegs, I had all that stuff, right? But when it came down to it, is I had to make a decision, say, well, what are you going to do, right? And I was thinking, you know what, I don't want to deal with this anymore. Because another thing that I noticed just through practice, when I would start listening to some things, and you could say, you know, on a scale of what's the most sinful, is listening to music like the most sinful thing you could do? No, it's not. Okay, it's not. But it does have a deeper impact on you that you really need to be aware of. Because oftentimes we'll tend to think, well, this isn't really that big of a deal. I mean, I'm not going off and committing fornication. Yeah, I'm listening to someone sing about it, but like, I'm not going and doing that. And, you know, praise God, maybe you've cleaned up a lot of things, you're doing really well in general, but you're allowing this stuff to come in. One of the things that I noticed, because this was my mindset, this is how I know there's no way I'm alone in thinking that way. And you're like, oh, that's not that big of a deal. Every single time, though, even after I already kind of knew that this stuff was wrong, I shouldn't be listening to it, every time that I would start listening to it, I'd always end up getting involved in other sin. Even sin that's not like one-to-one related, it's the mindset. One, I think music is very powerful, but it's also this mindset of just allowing for sin, like knowingly allowing sin is going to lead you into doing other sins that you didn't even really want to do anyways, but you're going to be a lot more likely to do that stuff. So what I had to do and what I recommend doing, it's actually worked really well, Because I thought about it, and there's a lot of value in it and stuff too, but I was like, you know what? I don't want someone else to have this problem, because it really is a plague. It's like if you have a bunch of booze, right? Maybe you have top shelf, really expensive booze. Booze is poison. What does that say about you if you're going to go and sell? Hey, do you want to buy this poison? Is the money really worth that much to you? You want to ruin their life by giving them that poison, giving them that drug? What if it were drugs? You got to just get rid of that stuff. Nobody ought to have it. Because I thought about selling all my meat. Well, some other people are like, if they want it, they'll go down and buy it at the record store anyway, so why don't I make some money off it? Well, the reason why is because you shouldn't be participating in evil. That's why. And you were foolish by spending your money. I was foolish by spending my money on it to begin with. I never should have done it. It was a waste. It was worse than a waste because it actually had an impact on my life spiritually, a negative impact. It's not good. So what I did was I took a chisel and I took a hammer and I smashed and destroyed because I didn't even want someone to dig it out of the garbage can. And I'm glad that I did that, because one of the things by doing that, what that did, that helped me to distance myself from that. In a similar fashion that, you know, after you get saved, you ought to get baptized. But once you get baptized, I've noticed this with many people. I've baptized personally in my own life. I've seen in other people's lives that once you get baptized, it really kind of gets you started spiritually going and dying to self and walking in the new man. It's symbolic of all of that, but it really does help you to do that. I know when I got baptized, things changed in my life when I decided to take that step of obedience, and I was really much more focused on serving the Lord. And in a similar way, when I took the chisel and the hammer to that music set, really cut that out. It's like cutting off a limb. And that's kind of how it felt when I was doing it, because I was looking at this stuff and going, oh man, I even had the cassette tapes, right? I was pulling the tapes out, you know, maybe that's a little bit old school for some of the people here. You don't know what I'm talking about, but the cassette tapes and the CDs, now everything's MP3 now. It's harder to do that, right? Because you could just like delete, but make sure you get out of the recycle bin. Don't leave it in there to just undelete it later. Like, get rid of it, wipe it clean.